seals. Any hydraulic system is associated with a major problem, that is leakage. This reduces efficiency and increases the power losses. Hence, sealing devices play a vital role in a hydraulic system by increasing the efficiency and decreasing the power losses. Leakage can be overcome by proper maintenance of the system and proper selection of seals and sealing at the design stage. Seals are used in hydraulic systems to prevent excessive internal and external leakage and to keep out contamination. Various functions of seals include the following. They prevent leakage, both internal and external. They prevent dust and other particles from entering into the system. They maintain pressure. They enhance the service life and reliability of the hydraulic system. Leakage in a hydraulic system can be classified as follows. Internal leakage. This occurs in hydraulic components built with operating clearances. Moving parts need to be lubricated and leakage path may be designed solely for this purpose. Internal leakage does not cause loss of fluid because the fluid returns to the reservoir. This leakage increases the clearances between mating parts due to wear. If the entire system leakage becomes large enough, the actuators do not operate properly. External leakage. External leakage represents loss of fluid from the system. It also represents a safety hazard. Improper assembly of pipe fittings is the most common cause of external leakage. Over-tightened fittings may become damages or vibrations can cause properly tightened fittings to become loose. Failure to connect drain lines, excessive operating pressure, and contamination might cause the fluid to externally leak. Classification of seals according to the method of sealing. Positive sealing. A positive seal prevents even a minute amount of oil from getting past. A positive seal does not allow any leakage whatsoever, external or internal. Non-positive sealing. A non-positive seal allows a small amount of internal leakage, such as the clearance of the piston, to provide a lubrication film. According to the relative motion existing between the seals and other parts. Static seals. These are used between mating parts that do not move relative to one another. These are relatively simple. They are essentially non-wearing and usually trouble-free if assembled properly. Dynamic seals. These are assembled between mating parts that move relative to each other. Hence, dynamic seals are subject to wear because one of the mating parts rubs against the seal. According to geometrical cross-section, O-ring seal. O-ring is the most widely used seal for hydraulic systems. It is a molded synthetic rubber seal that has a round cross-section in its free state. O-ring can be used for the most static and dynamic conditions. It gives effective sealing through a wide range of pressures, temperatures and movements, with added advantages of sealing pressure in both directions and providing low running friction on moving parts. V-ring seal and U-ring seal. V and U-ring seals are compression type seals used in virtually in all types of reciprocating motion applications. These include piston rods and piston seals in pneumatic and hydraulic cylinder press rank, jacks and seals on plungers and piston in reciprocating pumps. They are also readily suited to certain low rotary applications such as valve systems. These packings, which can be molded into U-shapes as well as V-shapes, are frequently installed in multiple quantities for more effective sealing. Tearing seal. Tearing seal is a dynamic seal that is extensively used to seal cylinder pistons, piston rods and other reciprocating parts. It is made of synthetic rubber molded in the shape of the cross section, tanned reinforced by backup rings on either side as shown in figure. The sealing edge is rounded and seals very much like an O-ring. Piston cup packings. Piston cup cap packings are designed specially for pistons in reciprocating pumps and pneumatic and hydraulic cylinders. They offer the best service life for this type of application, require a minimum recess space and minimum recess machining, and can be installed easily and quickly. In fastening the fabricated cup packing at the end of the piston, it is recommended that some provision be made to prevent the full pressure load from being taken on the bottom of the cup. Wiper rings and scraper rings. They are seals designed to prevent foreign abrasive or corrosive particles, materials from entering a cylinder. They are not designed to seal against pressure. They provide assurance against rod scoring and add materiality to packing life. The wiper ring is molded from a synthetic rubber which is stiff enough to wipe all dust or dirt from the rod, yet pliable enough to maintain a snug fit. The rings are easily installed with a snap fit into a machined groove in the gland. This eliminates the need for and expense of a separate retainer ring. According to the type of seal material used, seals are manufactured from a variety of material and synthetic materials. Earlier, leather, cork and impregnated fibers were used in hydraulic systems, but nowadays these are replaced by plastic and synthetic rubber materials. Synthetic rubbers, elastomers are compatible with oil. Elastomers can be made in various compositions to meet various operating conditions. Neoprene, chloroprene, bunion, silicone, teflon, tetrafluoroethylene, vitron. Natural rubber is rarely used as a seal material because it swells and deteriorates with time in the presence of oil. In contrast, synthetic rubber materials are compatible with most oils. Leather. This material is rugged and inexpensive, however it tends to squeeze when dry and cannot operate above 90 degrees Celsius, which is inadequate for many hydraulic systems. Leather does not operate well at cold temperatures to about minus 50 degrees Celsius. Bunion. This material is rugged and inexpensive and wears well. It has a rather wide operating temperature range, minus 45 to minus 110 degrees Celsius, during which it maintains its good sealing characteristics. Silicone. This elastomer has an extremely wide temperature range, minus 65 to minus 232 degrees Celsius. Hence, it is widely used for rotating shaft seals and static seals where a wide operating temperature is expected. Silicone is not used for reciprocating seal applications because it has a low tear resistance. Neoprene. This material has a temperature range of 50 to 120 degrees Celsius. It is unsuitable above 120 degrees Celsius because it has tendency to vulcanize. Tetrafluoroethylene. It is a tough, chemically inert, waxy solid which can be processed only by compacting and sintering. It has an excellent resistance to chemical breakdown up to temperatures of 370 degrees Celsius. It has an extremely low coefficient of friction. One major drawback is its tendency to flow under pressure, forming thin, feathery films. This tendency to flow can be greatly reduced by the use of filler materials such as graphite, metal wires, glass fibers, and asbestos. Viton. This material contains about 65% fluorine. It has become almost a standard material for elastomer type seals for use at elevated temperatures up to 2240 degrees Celsius. Its minimum operating temperature